Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on minority interest, and let's study regarding what all things are there, what exactly minority interest is all about. So let's get into the nitty-gritty of the same. Now, what's in the name? The famous, you know, age of the Shakespeare, you know, does not always hold. Minority interest is one such exception. As the name suggests, minority interest, if you go and see, can simply be defined as the value of a share or the interest that is attributable to the shareholdings less than 50%, okay, of the total number of shares. So shareholders holding less than 50% of the total outstanding number of shares are known as the minority shareholders. It is also known as the non-controlling interest, NCI. Okay, so in this tutorial, we are going to discuss a couple of things, but we'll start with first is what is minority interest. So in accounting world, minority interest means the ownership in subsidiary company not owned by the holding company. For a company to be a holding company, it must always hold more than 50% of the shares in its subsidiary company. Like, for example, let's say there is company A and there's this company B. They are the two shareholders of the company called, let's say, Pineapple Limited. Okay, they're holding 80% and 20% respectively. In the balance sheet of Pineapple Inc., shareholder B over here will be considered as the minority shareholder since it owns less than 50% of the total shares, and its net worth as on the date has to be shown under the separate head as a minority interest. Whereas shareholders A is the majority shareholders of the Pineapple Limited. So the concept of the minority interest arises only in the case when the company prepares two sets of the financial statements. So, a separate set of financial statements and consolidated financial statement. It is reported separately on only in the consolidated financial statement. See, minority interest adjustments occurs when the parent does not own 100% of the subsidiary. This is when it happens. Now, in the consolidated profit and loss account of minority interest is that proportion of the result for the year that relates to the minority holding. It is disclosed on the face of the consolidated profit and loss account under the profit on the ordinary activities of taxation. Now, as per IFRS, the minority interest is shown under the equity section of the consolidated balance sheet. Whereas if you see in case of the US GAAP, it can be reported under the liabilities and equities. So this is the case. Now, the reason for the separate line item with respect to the minority is to give a clear picture to the users of the financial statement about the various controlling interests in the company. It helps them in making an informed economic decision and also helps them in making comparison on the shareholding patterns of the different companies. It plays a huge role in analyzing various investment opportunity. That's a big thing in itself, and calls for its consideration while computing various ratios and analyzing the financial statement. Another reason for separate disclosure is to provide certain protection, you can say, to the minority shareholders, as they are in a position of a disadvantage. And since they are hardly involved in the decision-making process, there is no need to protect them operation or mismanagement of the conduct of the company's affairs by the management. So let's understand with the help of an example how minority interest has been calculated in a consolidated way. Let's see the calculation. Like as mentioned earlier by me, minority interest arises whenever a holding company owns a controlling interest which is less than 100%. So in a subsidiary company, so the claim of the shareholders on the net asset of the company are known as minority interest. This minority shareholders, like any other shareholders, have an equal but proportionate claim on the earnings and the assets of the subsidiary. The consolidated balance sheet comprises of all the assets and the liabilities of the subsidiary. Similarly, the consolidated income statement includes all the revenues and expense of the subsidiary. So the controlling interest of the parent company gives it enough right to manage of the net assets of the subsidiary, which justifies the inclusion of the 100% of the subsidiary's assets, liability, revenue, expenses in the consolidated statements. So let's start with an example. Let's assume that there is a company called 𝐖𝐡𝐚𝐭. It has acquired 80% of the equity shares in 𝐹𝐹𝐹 Inc. Okay, so for $650,000 in January 15, 2015. On the date of the acquisition, the book value of the equity was close enough to 6 lakh 50, which comprises of the equity share of 5 lakh and the retained earning of 1 lakh 50. So the exhibit over here shows us some details: the equity shares in amount, the percentage, what is attributable to 𝐖𝐡𝐚𝐭and what is attributable to the minority shareholders, and the retained earning details, that is 1 lakh 50, which will be again distributed in 80% and 20%. That gives your total equity bifurcation in 80 and 20. Let's see how the minority interest goodwill will be calculated and shown in the consolidated balance sheet. If you see, the 20% of 6 lakh 50, that is the total equity, 1 lakh 30, which will be the calculation of the minority shareholders. So the total equity into the minority shareholders ratio will give us the total value of the minority interest. Now the calculation of the goodwill, the amount paid for 80% of the equity share of for 𝐹𝐹𝐹 Inc, that is 6 lakh 50, and the book value of the 80% of the equity is just how much? 5 lakh 20, as you can see over here. So the difference is your goodwill or your capital reserve. So the excess amount that has been paid or goodwill is 1 lakh 30. So minority interest that will be showed will be 1 lakh 30, and in the intangible assets, the goodwill that will be amounting to 1 lakh 30. The minority interest 1 lakh 30 will not appear in the separate financial statement of either 𝐖𝐡𝐚𝐭 or 𝐹𝐹𝐹. So it won't be reported in the standalone financial statement. Rather, it will appear in the consolidated financial statement of 𝐖𝐡𝐚𝐭 Inc. Now let's understand the minority interest valuation. See, any valuation of a company requires a forecasting of the financial statement. So for the future, on the basis of the certain assumptions and parameter, while almost the financial figure has a direct relation with revenue and net profit, but forecasting the minority interest based on the revenue and net profit figures will lead to ambiguous data. Hence, in order to address the above issue, analysts have drawn out, four common methods or approaches for correct computation. The first one is called constant growth method. The second method is called the statistical growth method. The third method is called modeling each subsidiary separately. Okay, and this are the basically the methods, the three methods how the valuation has been done. So after discussing all this, let's make the final conclusion. Minority interest does provide the users of the financial statement with useful insight, which helps them to analyze and make us informed decision. The degree of the influence of the minority interest influences the decision making. Appointment of the directors on the board of directors of the company and fixing their compensation. Second, making the changes in the articles of the associations and important application regulatory provisions. Third, the registration of the company shares for initial public offerings. And finally, fourth, making changes in the capital structure of the company. So the concept of the minority interest has evolved over the time. In the past, it has not received a great deal of attention in the accounting literature. It was referred to as the liability, equity, or neither. Even as of today, there is a very little guidance on the treatment of the presentation of the minority interest, and there is no consensus on any position. Thank you, everyone.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.